guys. Today I'm going to be doing an everything bottle video. In this video, I'm going to be showing you my bottle collection, how I seal my bottles for my reborns, and how to make fake formula. So let's get started. Okay, so all of my bottles are sealed just because I sealed them all previously, but that's how I seal them, just the tips of it. A lot of people don't do this much because they want you to still be able to tell that it, or to make it look like it's not actually sealed. But I don't want them to leak, and I really don't care. People obviously know that I'm role-playing and that it's not a real baby, so they obviously know that nothing's coming out of the bottle, so I just seal it the way I want to. And I use... I use this premium silicone glue, and it is silicone 2 clear. General household repairs, and it's the waterproof and airtight one. You want to get them, obviously, because there's going to be liquid in your bottle, and so you want it to be waterproof. So I got this, and I got this at my local hardware store for a few dollars. It's not that expensive, and it really works. And you want to make sure you get the clear one, too, so that, because the bottle nipples are clear. So that is how I seal my bottles. And let's move on to how I make my fake formula. Okay, so I make fake formula a few ways, but since KBear already showed you one of my ways, I'm going to be showing you two other ways that I make it. You've probably seen both of these throughout the people on YouTube, but I figured I'd just show you anyways in case you haven't. And the two ways I do it is with water and sunscreen, or you could do lotion like KBear did. I just didn't want to do the same one. And they do have different looks, too, so you can decide which one you want. And I also use flour for, like, role-playing and stuff because it looks like actual formula. And you can put it in the bottles like it is formula and shake it up and stuff, and it looks just the same. So first, I'm going to be showing you the sunscreen way. Okay, so after you have the amount of water in your bottle that you want without the sunscreen or lotion in it, you're going to just add in some sunscreen. And I suggest to get, like, I know some sunscreens or lotions don't have the, like, plain white color. And if it's not that color, your bottle will obviously be not white. So after you have the amount you want in it, I'm just shaking it. And see, I only put 2 ounces in my bottle, and now it is up to 3 ounces. So just keep that in mind. So now you can obviously keep it like this, but bottles aren't a normal white color. They have a little bit of a goldish brown tint to it. So that's why we have the vanilla. You can use the like the Q-tip and the food dye method, but I feel like this gets you a better color. You don't want a lot of it in there just because you don't want it to turn brown. So what I do is I put it in the cap, because once you have it in there, you can't take it out. And I just put a little bit in the cap, and then I pour it in. And you can always come back and add more, but you can't take away any. So I just put a little bit in there, and I'm going to shake it up. And I think that's the right amount for me. It's kind of hard to tell, but it is now like a cream color, which looks more like formula. So that is one way you can make your formula. Now let's move on to the second way. Okay, so here's the second way of making it, and I use flour for this. I just keep it in like a little Pringles to go thing, just because I'll decorate it later, but just because it's kind of like a formula thing. But yeah, and then you're going to want your bottle with the amount of formula you want, or the amount of water you want in it, and then basically all you do is you add in your formula. Now the question is the amount of powder you want to put in, and it also depends on the amount of water you have. So I use two things when making it, two different things. I have this 1 teaspoon and 1/2 teaspoon spoon that I use for like from like medicine and stuff. Or I have this, I don't know how much is in this. It is like some little measuring thing that I've had from a Bitty Baby kitchen thing. So I also use that. And it looks like it won't fit into this one. I use this one for like the wider topped ones, but this one, if you put it in, it would spill. So I'm just been doing that. And I have 4 ounces in my bottle right now, so I'm gonna be doing 2 scoops of this. So 2 teaspoons. And you're just gonna put it in like a normal bottle. So I got 1 scoop. And 2 scoops. And then all you'll be doing is shaking it up. And now you have your puddle. And this is hard to tell. It isn't an off-white color. It is an off-white color. It's the creamish color. You just can't tell. It looks white in this, but it's actually not. Yeah, you can kind of tell it's a little brownish. But the only problem is if you're going to do the flour method is you can't keep this in the bottle for more than a day because it will spoil and it will make your bottle smell really bad. And I've had that happen to me before, and it's not the best thing in the world. It makes you gag. So if you're going to do this, I'd suggest only doing this for like role-playing videos and stuff just because it will spoil. And yeah, so this is how I make my fake formula for my Reborns. You saw all of my bottle collection, and I showed you how to seal your bottles with silicone. And so that is my everything bottle video. If you liked this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you have any video suggestions or things you want to see or any questions for us, leave it in the comments down below. And be sure to subscribe. We're only at 2 subscribers right now, or as of today. And we really, really, really want to get higher. So if you guys could help us reach our first goal of 10 subscribers, we would really appreciate it. And stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching. Bye.